In this video, I'm going to talk about how to put a sale on hold, what that does, and then also how to take that sale off of hold and go ahead and complete that transaction. So I'm in the Make a Sale screen now. I've gone ahead and selected a couple of items that my customer is going to be purchasing. Let's say that I need to put this sale on hold, for instance, because my customer needs to go pick up a different item from my store, or maybe she forgot her wallet and needs to run out to her car. In any case, I can put the sale on hold by clicking this Put on Hold button, and that allows me to continue to ring up other customers. When that customer returns to complete their transaction, I could recall that transaction by clicking on Held Receipts and then selecting that receipt from the list. If I had a couple, it's going to show me the details of that transaction over here. And as you can see, it just says it's marked held. I'm going to click Unhold, and then it's going to bring those items back onto that sales receipt for me to go ahead and close out. Another way to get those to come back is if I put this on hold again. Let's say I had to do some other tasks like receiving inventory or setting up a new customer. Then I could also just click on Held Receipts from the Navigator screen and click View. This would bring me back to that screen as well, where I could unhold that receipt. Now, it's important to note that until your sale or transaction is completed, so until I've clicked Save Only or Save and Print here and completely closed out this sale, my inventory quantities are not going to change. So if you are putting a receipt on hold, it's not going to deduct those inventory quantities from your inventory until that sale is completed. So I'm just going to say the customer is paying with cash now. Save. And now I'm ready to check out my next customer.